Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Last session we have seen about HTML, inserting videos, sound, images and all, right? In that we were seeing about form tags. We saw about input tags, right? We saw about type, name, value, size, maximum length and all, right? In that we saw, I have said you to refer the code or the program which is given in page number 277, right? Let's see the HTML code to demonstrate form and form controls, that is the login form, right? First they have opened the HTML tag, head tag, and then title. Title they have given and the title tag is also closed, and then we have to close the head tag, right? They have not mentioned that line there. You have to write the slash headline before body tag, right? And then body tag is opened, and then heading 3, H3, align is equal to center, and the heading is given and slash H3. They have closed the heading tag, and after that they have opened the form tag, right? In form we saw action, form action is equal to, you have to give the name. And then method is equal to, you have to give either get or post. Here they have given post, right? And then next they have given a p tag, that is starting a next paragraph, so it will come as a next new line, right? So username, that name will be there, and there you need text, right? You have to enter some name there, so you need a text box, right? So input type is equal to text, then name is equal to username, then we have to give the size attribute we saw, right? Size is equal to 20. So in this name username we'll get a text box, and it will enter 20 characters, right? Maximum length is equal to 15, and then they have closed to the p tag, that is that paragraph is closed. And the next one, same way for password, we are giving password. Input type is equal to password. Password means the thing you are entering will be displayed as a coded or in an asterisk form. And then name is equal to pass, and then in that also size and maximum length they have mentioned. And then we need a reset button. Input type is equal to reset. Value is equal to clear. We'll have a reset button, and in that it will be written as clear. Same way submit button. Submit and the value it will be written as login. And then they have closed to the slash form tag and slash body slash HTML. That's all, right? When you are entering this code, we'll get the output like this, right? The first heading is there, and then username, we'll have a text box, password, we'll have a password box, and then clear and login button, right? And then let's see about the next program which they have given page number 278, right? HTML code to demonstrate form and form controls, that is in text box, checkbox, radio buttons, this and all, right? Here also in the same way we have seen in that previous coding, HTML, head tag, title tag, and then head tag they have closed, body tag, and inside the body tag first the headlines is given as form and control, forms and control, and then form action is equal to the name they have given, method is equal to post, and then in that same way like username, here they have given student name and the name, size and maximum length. And then next one, if you see, they have entered gender. For that we need radio button, right? So here input type is equal to radio, name is equal to gender, and in value they have given boy, and we need boy and girl, right? So they have given two lines. The lines will be same only, type radio, type is equal to radio, name is equal to gender. In the first line value is equal to boy, and after closing that input tag boy is written there. And next line, if you see, same line only, in the place of boy they have given girl, and after closing that input tag girl is there and slash p. So that paragraph tag has been closed, right? And the next one, next paragraph tag, subjects, in that checkbox, same line only, input type is equal to checkbox, name is equal to subject, value is equal to, in this place you have to give each values, right? If you are giving countries, you will be giving India, America, Maldives, like that you will be giving each values there, and after closing the input tag, and after that also you will give the name again. Whatever you are giving in after this only will be displayed here in this checkbox, right? And after giving all this options, you'll close the particular paragraph tag, right? If you are not giving this paragraph tag, it will come, but it will be having no space, right? Here, since we are giving this paragraph tag and closing paragraph tag in each line, here we'll have enough space in between each lines, right? And the next one is the same way, reset and submit button, right? There we saw clear and submit, right? And after that, they have closed slash form, slash body, slash HTML, right? Are you clear? If you have any doubts, you can ask me through WhatsApp, right? And the next one, in 279, they have given select tag, right? Next one is select tag. Here, select tag means this is used to create a drop-down list box in this HTML, okay? Here, some options will be there in the drop-down list box, right? Like that, some choice will be there. For that, we need this select tag, right? Here, this element is helpful when you have many options which cannot be displayed in the limited space, right? If you are having only 5 options, you will use this checkbox, right? If you are having some 10 or 20 options, if you are displaying that 10 or 20 options on the form, it will take a huge space, right? So here we'll prefer only this drop down list box, right? Let's see what are the attributes which will come under this select tag, right? Name will be there. Here we have to give the name to which this has to be sent, right? And the next one, size means you have to determine the style of this drop down list box. So style means here size 1 means drop down list box, size 2 list box, like that. Size also you have to determine here, and multiple, allow user to select multiple values, that is a another attribute. And next one is option tag. If you use here, you'll have some attributes. Selected, indicate the default selection. Value to be submitted to server, right? Here, if you see, if you are using this multiple attribute, if you are using in this drop down list box, you may have two, or if you are having 10 subjects, you can select more than one subject, means you'll use this multiple attribute, right? If you can only select one, you won't use this multiple attribute, right? And sometimes if the user is not selecting anything, as a default one, some subject or something will be selected, means it will be given as selected. If you are using this selected attribute along with option tag, it will indicate the default selection there, right? Then value means value which has to be submitted to the server, that one is value attribute, right? Here if you see this example, you will get an idea. Here you know HTML, head tag, title tag, and closing the head tag, you know. After that, they have opened the body tag, and then same in the previous coding we have seen, that same way it is given, they have given the heading there, forms and controls, and form action is equal to, and the name they have given, and then method is equal to post, right? Then student name, that is a text box. And after that, city or town they have mentioned here. In that, they have given select name is equal to area, right? Area, that one you have to select. Size is equal to 1. Option value, first they have given Chennai, Madurai, Coimbatore, Kanyakumari. That means same way only, each line will have each names, right? Chennai, then they are closing the option tag. The next one, Madurai, then closing the option tag. And then the next one, Coimbatore, they have closed the option tag, right? And at last, they have closed the select tag, right? And then input type is equal to reset. Name is equal to reset value is equal to clear. Reset value clear. That is for reset button. That is clear button and submit button, right? This is the same thing which we have seen in the previous two codings, right? Are you clear? So, the thing will be displayed in this way. See? We'll have a column as city or town, and the next column will have the drop down list box, right? When you just click it, we'll have Chennai, Madurai, Coimbatore, Kanyakumari. Which one we need, you can just select it and submit, right? That is the thing we have seen here, option and select, right? And the next one is text area. Text area is used to receive multi-line text data as input, right? It is a container tag. That means here the main attributes of text area, you will have name, rows, columns, right? A text area means it is like a text box which will have for typing some address or some feedbacks, and all will have some text area, right? Name means that is used to define the name to the control. Row means it will specify the number of rows in the text area. Column means it will specify the number of columns in the text area, right? So here in this text area we'll have name, rows and columns, right? Here in this example, if you see in page number 280, right? If you see in this body tag, first heading and then form tag they have opened, and then the text box, and next one after comment, if you see, they have started text area rows is equal to 5, calls is equal to 50, name is equal to comments, and then text area have closed to the text area, right? If you see the output here, we have a box. It will have 5 rows and 50 columns, right? Very clear. That is the text area, right? So next one, they have given a full student data entry form, right? When you are seeing this, you'll get a clear idea how to create a form, right? You just see the program or the coding which they have given in page number 281, right? HTML tag, head tag, and then title. Title you can give whatever you need, and then close the title tag and then close the head tag. Then body tag you have to open, and in that first you'll give the heading, right? So we have given H3, heading must be in center. So align is equal to center. After giving the heading, you'll close the heading tag, right? Slash H3. And then form action is equal to first the name, and then method is equal to post, right? And then they opened the paragraph tag. You will need it in a new paragraph, right? You'll have a space front and back, so up and down you'll have some space. So we'll use this paragraph tag in each line, right? Student name, that you need a text box for that. Input type is equal to text, and then name is equal to, you have to give some name there. Size and maximum length they have given, and then close the paragraph tag. And then next one is for email, same way they have used the text box. And then gender, they have used a radio button. Input type is equal to radio, name is equal to gender, and value is equal to, you have to enter the values, and after closing the input tag you have to enter the value again, right? And then you can close the paragraph tag. And then next one, input type is equal to checkbox. In subjects we'll have checkbox, name is equal to, you have to give subject, value is equal to, you can give any value there. How it will be displayed means after closing this input tag you will give something here, right? In the right corner it's, they have given Tamil, Telugu, English, physics, economics and all. So in this way only it will be displayed in that form tag, right? After this, the checkbox is done, and we'll close this paragraph tag, right? And then next one, next paragraph tag is opened, city or town. Select name is equal to area. Option value we have seen here in select tag, right? Option and the value tag we have used, and CHN. Here you can give anything, right? Inside this option tag you can give anything. And before, after closing the option tag, that is after option value is equal to, you can give some value and you can close it. And after that you will give something, right? Chennai, that will be displayed in the list, in the list in that form, right? And after giving that you will close the option tag slash option. In that you can give a number of options you need, right? And then a text area, for that we have seen it already. They have opened a paragraph tag and comments. They have used a break, BR, that means a comments, that one will be in a single line, and in the next line you'll have the text area. So they have used BR, break, right? Text area rows is equal to 5, calls is equal to 50. So this text area, this box will have 5 rows and 50 columns. Name is equal to comment, and then text area is closed, slash text area slash P, right? And then we need a clear and submit button. For that, input type is equal to reset, name is equal to reset, value is equal to clear. Whatever value you are giving inside this double quotes will be displayed in this button, right? And the next one is input type is equal to submit, name is equal to submit, value is equal to submit. So we'll get a submit button. And then slash form. So the form tag is closed, slash body. Body tag is closed, slash HTML. HTML tag is closed. You will get the output in this way, right? So today we have seen about creating a form. We have seen text box. We have seen a password box, checkbox, radio button, drop down list, text area, and clear and submit buttons also. So you will have a clear idea of creating HTML forms, right? You know to create a form in a web page using HTML, right? You know how to insert image, you know how to insert a video and also audio in a web page, right? The next chapter, that is in the next session, we'll be seeing about cascading style sheet. We'll be creating style sheets using in this HTML, right? So you know how to create a web page. You have learned about HTML thoroughly, right? So before going to CSS, that is the next chapter, you make sure you are clear with this HTML, right? You can just see this codings and write it and see. If you are having computer, just work it out and see, right? You can just open a notepad, type this code, and you can save it in, how will you save? You will give a name dot HTML, right? And after that, if you are opening that particular, you will have a, if you are saving it with dot HTML, you will have a icon, browser icon, right? In the place, you have, if you are saving it in desktop, you can just see a browser icon there, right? If you are clicking that name which you have saved, it will just open it in a browser icon. If you have typed the coding correctly, if you are opening the HTML tag, you have to close the HTML tag. If you are opening a body tag, you have to close the body tag. Everything if you are giving correctly, you will get the result in the web page correctly, right? If you are getting some error in the web page, or if that web page is not getting the desired output, you have to check the coding again, right? So try it out before attending our next session. Okay, next session we'll see about cascading style sheets and all, right? Thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.